Welcome back, everyone. Today, we're diving into the latest updates on the budget and the exchange rate situation in Iraq. Host, that's what we are waiting for as we speak, to see what's in the budget. We haven't seen them expose that rate or that information to us just yet, but they're going to. They don't have much choice because on June 12th, the budget became law. The court already said, just because they have an appeal doesn't mean they have any weight to them. Why haven't we had a new exchange rate? It's always the same answer. It's the corruption from Iran that steals from the auctions from the CBI. Government through the political people that they have. Saleh is on TV saying they have no cash supply issue and that Iraq is positioned as the strength of the Middle East. Frank. Because they are about to flood you with lower notes. There's no liquidity issue. He's trying to tell you they're about to give you purchasing power. Host. So, as investors, where do we stand with the RV? Based on the information from my Saturday call to Iraq, here's a summary for you. We're still waiting for the US to give assurances. The project to delete the zeros was scheduled for June, and we still have a week remaining in June. This is all I know and can tell everyone at this point. But I was told last month that for us to see the RV, there were only two phases, and they were completing the second phase in June. So go figure. What would you think now? Host. My CBI contact said that her committee was directed to be ready in June and did plan in June to begin the project to delete the zeros. But the central bank has not yet received the assurances needed in writing from the US Treasury that they would support us fully all the way through the process. This means to conduct the project to delete the zeros, swap out the notes, and then onward to the reinstatement of the diner. I was assured I was correct in my thinking. I already knew this as this was all in the Dr. Shabibi plan anyway. This was just a confirmation that they are still closely following this part of the plan. The US is still holding back and not fully supporting the financial reforms and the events that were supposed to happen at the end of the second phase of the reform process. Do we know for sure if we will be taxed at our exchange or not? Mark Z. We do not know for sure. It's best to plan on being taxed and hope you are not. I do not think we are going to be taxed. Most of my sources say we will not, but I am prepared if they are wrong. I strongly believe the rate is contained in a budget, not the budget, but a budget because we have three of them that we're dealing with. You can stop asking questions about the budget. It's all there. Concerning the tripartite budget, everything, all the projects, cities, new exchange rate, lower notes, ATM machines, contracts, everything, it is all there. It is a fact. The GOI has the budget, and they have the new exchange rate from the CBI. Experts are likely to keep exchange rates within their current rates. It's not going to happen that quickly. There are so many more hurdles for Iraq to jump through. Cut to a news clip featuring Iraqi Prime Minister Mohammed Shia al-Sudani. Iraqi Prime Minister Mohammed Shia al-Sudani stressed the importance of networking between border ports and continuing to complete the automation system for customs. His media office said that al-Sudani chaired a meeting to follow up on the implementation of networking between the border crossings and to complete the customs automation system, ASICUDA. During the meeting, several topics were discussed, including the summary of the implementation of the second phase of the ASICUDA system, the first phase of the border ports management system, and the completion of network connectivity in addition to the system for monitoring trucks and their weights on the roads without stopping them. Al-Sudani stressed the importance of this file in various economic, administrative, supervisory and technological aspects and its implications for maximizing non-oil treasury revenues, activating sectors, and simplifying procedures. All of these represent an essential part of the economic reform priorities contained within the government program. The meeting witnessed the approval of next September as a date to stop dealing with the paper system and work with the electronic system at customs. The Prime Minister also directed to hold a workshop to follow up and draft the customs law, as well as to follow up on the link between the Central Bank of Iraq and private banks and support the networking system and management of border crossings. The meeting also decided to strengthen the work of the General Authority of Customs with expertise through specialists and technicians from the Ministry of Higher Education and Scientific Research in the field of computers and e-government. That's all for today's update. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay informed on the latest developments. Thanks for watching. See you next time.